just as Harry said. It's crowded and quiet. Hey, Brian.
Agent. Mr. Agent, how are you?
Not bad. I'm, just playing a little game with Harry.
Game? A game? Is that fun?
We've only just started, Brian. The fun is about to begin. I'd like to ask you something, actually. Is there a tree in the graveyard that drops red seeds?
Seeds? Red seeds? That tree does. And that one. And that one, too. All red seeds.
Bullseye. Amazing. Bullseye. Amazing. Nice shot. Amazing. Nice shot. Great. Yes. Bullseye. Amazing. Bullseye. Bullseye. Yes. Nice shot. Amazing.
Zach, mission accomplished. Let's get back to Harry's. The reward better be good. But you know, about these seeds, they were right here under my nose. It's as if I was carefully carrying a bottle of water while walking in a pool.
We're learning the countryside version of common sense the hard way, Zach.
It's a shame.
Mr. Francis York Morgan, finally you have arrived. You are welcome to come inside.
Mr. Francis York Morgan, please proceed to Mr. Stewart's room. There he awaits you, I shall assume.
Yes?
Mm-hmm.
Harry, turns out what you said was true, and I'd like to hear more.
York, as you know, there's a powerful mystery surrounding these seeds. You've seen them at those other murders that took place elsewhere. And you've seen them deeply involved with the murders in this town as well.
That's right. But how do you know all this?
York, you must be younger than you look. Youngsters tend to hurry so much that they let things slip right past them.
What you need to do is slow this down a bit. That way you'll see what's really important. Let me tell you a story. 50 years ago, when the war was over, just about when the Communist Red started to become a rising threat, our town constructed a huge clock tower. Then, soon afterwards, a serial killer wearing a red raincoat went on a killing spree.
The legend of the Raincoat Killer? Stop playing games with me, Harry. That's nothing more than folklore. The FBI has no such record of a multiple homicide case in this town.
York, Anna, Becky, and now Diane. Their deaths are real, not folklore, not legend.
The Raincoat Killer is also real, but under a strict gag order, the mass murder case was never made public. In fact, one could say that it was completely erased from history. Tell me, who do you think would be able to do something like that?
The military.
Very good. A model student.
But if there are no records about it, then how do you know it really happened?
Good question, York. Why would I know this? The answer is very simple. I was there.
I saw it with my own eyes. The brutal killer himself. But we can talk about the details of that encounter another time. What we need to talk about is your raincoat killer. The new raincoat killer, if you will. The new raincoat killer. Yes, let's call him that. After all, he's not the real one. What you want to know more about is the new one. Between 10 and 20 years ago, I noticed that these red seeds were special, and someone else did too. The human imagination can lead to tragedy sometimes. Someone linked the red seeds to the serial killer legend and said, if you eat the red seeds and then kill someone, you will become immortal. This new fabricated legend was passed on from one to the next, evolving and changing every time, like a rumor. Some may have actually taken the seeds to try them out, to prove the legend, that is. York! Seeds you have found from those other murders. They all came from this town, together with that one evil rumor. People on the other side of the planet may have heard of it by now. And new seeds might be growing in different parts of the world.
So you're saying that the series of cases I've been following are all linked to this town? That's interesting, Harry. But there's no evidence to support that story. None of the criminals we caught for the other murders ever mentioned anything like that.
It's your job, your role and duty to look into that, York. Now, the game must go on. You know I said that the incident 50 years ago was totally erased. Well, not quite. Records still exist in the sheriff's office. The old sheriff back then hated the military and did his own investigation. I need you to bring those documents here to me. Once you've done that, I'll tell you everything I know.
Okay, it's worth a look. And we may as well let the old man have his fun.